Good morning, everyone. It's Mark from Ford Mustang 98 Guy. Today, we are going to take a full in-depth walk-around look at the 2005 Chevrolet Silverado. This is a 1500. This is a rear-wheel drive model. It's not four-wheel drive. It's a short bed. Today, I'm going to give you all a full and in-depth tour and walk-around of the Silverado. I'm going to start it up. I'm also going to show the engine, and I'm going to show you all the inside and the outside of the truck. This truck almost has close to 200,000K on it. I'll show you the mileage when we get inside. So, without further ado, let's sit inside, start it up, let it run. Here goes the key for the vehicle. This is all I got right here. I don't have a key fob or anything. The color of the exterior is red. It's got gray cloth interior. And this one's actually a rare find. When I meant to say rare, I know it's basic, but the reason why I'm saying rare, because this one is a 5-speed manual, that's why it makes it so rare. It's got 197,000K on it. That's a lot of kilometers for a 2005. But the truck is already 12 years old, but still, it's in great shape. And I apologize to the about the weather, it's raining today. Anyway, let's start it up. Where's neutral? Oh, hang on. There we go. Hold on, I'm just gonna make sure it's in neutral. Neutral. And we'll take the key. I'll fire it up. Fires right up. Close the door for a sec. It is raining today. Four spoke design steering wheel. It's not leather wrapped. Very easy to turn. This one's a 5-speed manual transmission. That's why it makes it so rare, because I've never seen a Silverado with a 5-speed manual. You can never find a Silverado with the standard transmission. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, and then all the way over. I'm trying to get it in, but I believe that's reverse. Sometimes it's a little bit tricky to get into, but I'll go through the gears one more time so you guys understand what I'm talking about. 5-speed manual gearbox. It is a 5-speed manual. First, second, third, fourth, all the way to the right, up is fifth, and then all the way over and down is reverse. So you get the process. Parking brake is located down there with the brake release. As you can see, it works. I'll just keep it on because I have it out of gear. As you can see, it works. All right, let's turn on the automatic headlights and the hazards. Sorry about it, it's raining today. It's got manual windows. Pretty basic truck, but manual locks. It's got manual everything, it doesn't have power features. Let's show you all the outside. Yeah, too bad it's got no options. But what makes it so rare is that I never seen a Silverado this body style with a manual. This was a one owner truck, but the body's been painted, and I'll show you where it's been painted. I apologize about the long wait. I know it's been a long time since I've been making videos, but like I said, the weather's been shit. It's been raining a lot, and we've had a lot of snow lately. That's why I didn't make a lot of videos throughout March, because and April, because the weather was bad, and plus I'm busy with work, so that's another thing why I've been making videos for a while. These are riding on hand-cooked tires. And these are 245/70 R17 tires.
Gas cap.
So I'll show you where the body's been painted. You can look under there, that's where it's been painted. The owner told me that, well, this is the same guy who had that 96 B-Series, but unfortunately that one got in an accident. And the guy who had that truck, he just bought this 5 months ago. So, this is the same guy who had the B-Series and who previously had that 94 F-150. You guys remember that truck? It's the same guy. The B-Series, unfortunately, he had an accident with that one. He got T-boned. And the insurance wrote it off, and then the truck had to go, unfortunately. But at least I got a video of it. And to be honest with you, this one's actually in pretty good condition for the age. Being a 2005, this truck. There's the tailgate. Pretty basic though. There's your exhaust. Now open the hood. Underneath the hood is the 4.3 liter V6. This is not the V8, this is the V6 engine, the 4.3 liter. Runs pretty good. Got an interstate battery. Yeah, I apologize about the rain, folks. Yeah. Pretty basic truck. Manual windows as well, manual locks. Storage down there, fully manual driver's seat. Does have a tilt steering wheel as well. So, I'm just gonna roll this window back up. All right, we'll give her a few revs. Engine's already been warmed. See how she revs. Engine lights on. Nice. Now I'll do a review on the inside. Here's your headlights off to this side. climate control. It's very easy to use. Fan speed. You have your different zones, along with your front defrost. Temperature on this side. You can adjust it to cold or hot. It's very easy to use by these three dials. Down here, you have a power outlet. A little bit of storage in there. Another power outlet or cigarette lighter. Ashtray as well. Little storage cubby. Sure out of gear. If I shift it into gear, it's gonna stall. We're close. AM FM radio. It's a basic setup. Nothing fancy.
As anyone else, where he said that after all of us.
Let's do a sound test.
Credit 700.ca.
Trying to find a good station here.
God, there you stand before me and I respect my glory. If you prove my glory, I'ma drop the hell and get gory. I did everything except worry, hella drama, my life story. Faith of a mustard seed, I kept growing. I knew that this life was meant for me. People change that morning with some wells. Karma come around, I wish some well. Living like a
stereo sounds good.
Of Oz, that's what's underneath it, and I think that's what's...
Preset stations?
A couple of months ago, man, was about a month and a half ago, we had this, the Broadway...
The bench seats. No, there's nothing really much to see on this truck.
Studios, and these guys
I think this is a third seat so you can bring three people along.
Yeah.
I don't think it comes down,
really
though.
Great, and we had this really, really cool conversation.
I don't think this seat,
they talked a little bit about
this thing here comes
Hamilton,
down.
And I asked them how they felt about Hamilton, which of course is kind of the question asked to every Broadway composer these days.
Nothing really much to see.
Well, you know,
cup holders down there.
Old enough to remember when West Side Story came out, and that was supposed to change everything, and it didn't.
Trying to raise it down a
little
bit.
And I remember when Rent came out, and that was supposed to change everything.
Off to this side,
and now
you have your wipers and turn signals.
And it's expected to change everything, and he doesn't think it will. But now you're seeing like
here's your wipers
come from away, and of course Hamilton. Where do you see musical theater evolving?
Low speed.
Where do you stand
and high speed?
First of all, full disclosure, the writer of Hamilton, Lin-Manuel Miranda, is a very good friend of mine, mm-hmm. And so I'm a huge admirer.
It's got no buttons on the steering wheel, it's just a basic setup.
That being said, I think one of the things that...
No mirror or anything like that, but it does have slide-outs. It's got the
really
slide-out
deep knowledge of
extensions,
locked
sun,
musical theater structure,
but no mirror, sadly.
He writes, of course, in his own style, which involves hip-hop and rap. That being said, underneath,
yeah, just basic setup.
A very classically structured
not sure what happened
story.
There.
It has, you know,
oh, well.
I want song. It has a
your gauges.
Story.
Here's your gauges. Full set of gauges. Over here, you have your tachometer,
things,
speedometer, gas gauge, oil gauge,
mm-hmm.
engine temperature gauge, and a battery gauge, and the odometer. Trip computer.
With his own very personal and very contemporary
engine hours.
So you mentioned the personal style that Lin-Manuel brought to Hamilton, the personal style that these composers bring to shows like Come From Away. What about you? When you look at all the work that
manually
you've done,
dimming rearview mirror,
is a distinctive Stephen Schwartz style or sound that comes through?
Well, people tell me there is, and you know, of course, I can't tell that about myself. What I will say is that when I first started writing, you know, you cited Godspell, which is early 70s.
It's not a bad truck.
The prevailing sound on Broadway, Broadway musicals, was sort of classic musical.
That's nice.
And the idea,
but pretty basic. It's got no options at all. But cloth interior hasn't got nothing. But it does have a 5-speed manual.
Just not done.
Anyways, that's pretty much about it for the interior.
The other early writers,
yeah, too bad it's raining today.
Who did that,
shut that off. It's getting warm in here.
All
right, now we'll continue on with the tour. And there's the 2001 Explorer Eddie Bauer I videoed last year. It's still running great. I haven't talked to the owner in a while, but he still has it. He just drove by me about a second ago. You guys remember that white 2001 Explorer Eddie Bauer that I videoed last year? The guy still has it. I haven't talked to the owner in a while though, but he sure does have it. truck's in good shape. For being a 2005, it's mint. Well, it's not perfect, but still, it's actually, the paint is actually pretty clean. Pretty basic on this side, basic setup. I don't think this comes down, I'm not sure. Oh yeah, I got a little tear over here. 12-year-old truck, you can't do anything about it. Never seen a Silverado with a manual gearbox. That's the farthest the seat goes back.
So I guess I should imitate something like that. Mm-hmm. I should write a show like Hamilton. I should write a show like Dear Evan Hansen. That's never really been the key, and I think that may be what Richard and David were saying when you talked to them.
Stephen, I can't begin to tell you what an enjoyable conversation this was. Thank you so much.
Thank you. It's great to talk to you.
Pretty cool, eh? Stephen Schwartz is an Oscar and Grammy Award-winning American musical theater.
Yeah, it's pretty small in there, but...
God, that's a lot. He's just a legend.
And this is the owner's book.
And I should add, I spoke to him.
This is the owner's manual.
Nominations, which celebrate the best work.
But it's all ripped up, unfortunately.
Broadway season. For a full list of the nominees, we'll post a link on our Twitter. Our Twitter handle is at CBC Radio Q.
This one's got a mirror on this side, but it's pretty dusty. Slide out extension to block out the sun. Ocean handle. And that's pretty much about it for the truck. I guess we'll just lock that door up. And we'll shut it off. That's it. All right. And we will shut her down. Now take the key out. All you gotta do is push this button, turn back, and that's it. That's all you have to do. And the key is out. You just have to push that button and turn. Hope you guys enjoyed the full in-depth tour and walk around of the 2005 Chevrolet Silverado 1500 short bed. Stay tuned for my next video. We'll see you next time. Hope you guys have a great day. Take care, subscribe for more, and make sure to like, comment, all that good stuff. Have a great day, everyone.